हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल. माय सेल्फ योजना कुमावत, लेक्चरर इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग ऑफ केकेवाक पॉलिटेक्निक नाशिक. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस साइक्लोन सेपरेटर विद यू फ्रॉम द सब्जेक्ट प्लांट यूटिलिटी ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर डिप्लोमा इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग. दिस साइक्लोनिक सेपरेशन इज अ मेथड ऑफ रिमूविंग द पार्टिकुलेट्स फ्रॉम एन एयर, गैस और लिक्विड स्ट्रीम without the use of filters through the vortex separation. When removing the particulate matter from a liquid, a hydrocyclone is used, while from gas, a gas cyclone is used. These gas cyclones are widely used in the industry for the separation of particles from gas and air stream. And the water cyclones, which is also called as hydrocyclones, are used for the separation of fluids of differing densities. It is available in a wide range of material of construction like cast iron, ductile iron, carbon steel and the stainless steel. The cyclone separators are suitable for separating the particles about 5 micrometer in diameter, and the smaller particles down to about 0.5 micrometer can be separated where the agglomeration occurs. Here we can see, or this slide shows the diagram of cyclone separator. Actually, these cyclones are separation devices that use the principle of inertia to remove the particulate matter from the flue gases. Here we can see this cyclone separator consists of this cylindrical tank, and it also consists of this cone shaped tank, and it consists of this inlet, tangential gas inlet, okay, and the clean gas goes to the atmosphere through this outlet. Okay, now we will see the working of this cyclone separator. The flow stream of gases enters the body of the separator tangentially from this tangential inlet duct at the top, and it begins to swirl due to the circular design of the chamber until it reaches the bottom. The material that are denser than the carrier medium are separated from the stream during this downward flow. Means the solid particles which are present in the gases get thrown towards the wall of this cyclone separator, and from this wall they goes at the bottom of the cyclone separator, and from this portion or from this outlet all the solid particles are removed from the cyclone separator. As the mixture is circulating down the funnel, it creates a whirlpool effect in the middle of the cone. This causes a vortex in the center of the cone through which the lighter flow stream rises and it goes upward. As the fluid or vapor reaches the top of the vortex, it is passing by the difference in the pressure through a tube that sticks down into the center of the funnel. Okay, and this tube is called as vortex finder. This is called as vortex finder. And from this, the clean gases from the cyclone separator goes to the atmosphere. In this figure, we can see the top view of the outer vortex and the inner vortex. We have seen this single cyclone separator. This single cyclone separator create a dual vortex to separate coarse from fine dust. The main vortex spirals downward and carries most of the coarser dust particles. The inner vortex created near the bottom of the cyclone spirals upward and carries the fine dust particles. On the basis of the entry of the dirty gases inside the cyclone separator, they are classified into the three types. First is a cyclone with the tangential entry. This type of cyclones have a distinctive and easily recognized form, and they are widely used in the power and cement plants, feed mills and many other process industry. In this figure, we can see the dirty gas comes inside the cyclone separator through tangentially. Next type is the axial entry cyclones. In this figure, we can see the dirty gas is entering axially inside this cyclone separator, which is parallel to the axis of this cyclone body. In this case, the dust laden gases enter from the top and are directed into the vortex pattern by the vanes attached to the central tube. Axial entry units are commonly used in multi-cyclone configuration, as these units provide the higher efficiencies. And the next type is cyclone with a tangential entry from bottom. In this figure, we can see the dirty gases entering inside this cyclone separator tangentially, but from the bottom of the cyclone separator. It is often used after wet scrubber to trap the particulate matter entrained in the water droplet. In this type, the air enters tangentially at the bottom, forming the vortex. Larger water droplets are forced against the wall and are removed the air stream. For achieving the higher efficiency of gas purification, the cyclone separators are arranged parallelly, and this is called as the multi-cyclone separator. It consists of number of small diameter cyclones operating in a parallel and having a common gas inlet and the outlet, which is shown in this figure. The multi-cyclones operate on the same principle as the cyclones, creating a main downward vortex and ascending inner vortex. The multi-cyclones are more efficient than the single cyclones because they are longer and smaller in diameter. The longer length provides longer residence times, while the smaller diameter creates greater centrifugal force. These two factors result in better separation of dust particulates. That's why these multi-cyclone separators are generally used in the industry. For the designing of cyclone separator, some features to be considered. First is high efficiency over a broad flow range. Second is flow optimized design. Third one is low pressure drop, resulting in energy saving. Fourth one is high safety during operation under pressure. And fifth one is long-term corrosion protection. Advantages of cyclone separators are: it is simple and inexpensive to manufacture, and it requires little maintenance. It contains no moving parts. The cyclone separator has the ability to operate at a high temperature and pressure. And unlike the slow setting, within a settling tank, the pump and the cyclone separator system yields fast separation and utilizes less space. Cyclone separators are used for the removal of dust particles from emission from the cotton gins, grain elevators, tractors, grain mixers and other agricultural machinery. In the food industry, for the separation of agglomerated particles and for the separation of starch and protein. They are also used for the cleaning of flue gases from power plants. Cyclone separators are used in oil refinery to separate oil and gases. They are also used in cement industry, and the cyclone separator is also used in the vacuum cleaner. Thank you everyone. We will meet soon with my new video. Thank you.